Logistic regression is a model used to perform binary classification, that is categorizing a given input to either 0 or 1, and I will be using this model from Scikit-Learn to predict if a person has heart disease or not. The dataset that we will be using on in this video was acquired from Kaggle. Let's start with importing all the modules that we will need. So we will first need the logistic regression from Scikit-Learn, so sklearn.linearModel. We will have to import logistic regression like that, and then I'm also going to import the train test split because we will have to split the data into 80-20 anyways. So from sklearn dot model selection, this is where the train test split is, so import train test split underscore test underscore split, and then also from scikit-learn metrics I will import the accuracy score to evaluate the model. I will also import standard scaler because I'm just going to scale the features in terms of the input label X because it has wide range of values. So from sklearn pre-processing, I'm going to use the standard scaler. You can use the min-max if you wish. So standard scaler, like that. And of course, the three very important modules, pandas, spd, numpy, snp, and then we will also have to import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Now let's run our code. Alright, so now we will have to load in the data to our data frame and then make the necessary adjustments and formatting that we will need. So our data frame will be pd.read underscore csv, and then we pass in the file path like this. And then let me just first type in df head to see if that really worked. Yes, we do have the table which contains 16 columns, and the last column is what we will have to build our logistic regression model onto. So what I will do first is I'll just type in isNA dot sum. This will return the number of none values in each and every single column. So let's just run this, and we see that education column has 105 none values. So what I will do first is drop this education column because this column is not actually needed when it comes to predicting if a person has heart disease or not. So what I will do is type in df.drop and then pass in the columns to be education, like that. Now when you run this code, I guess we have to type in small e, I'll just run our code. I also have to type in place equal to true to make sure that the changes take place then and there. Now when you run this code, you see that there is no education column. So now when you get to the next one, which is the cigarettes per day if the person is a current smoker. So what we can do for this one is just simply drop all of the records that contains none value in terms of the cigarettes per day. So what I will do is our updated df will be df of 6 per day, the column that we're actually manipulating now, per day, and just type in not NA. So this will return all of the records where 6 per day column is not 0, and then we're just updating that to our latest data frame. Now when you run this, we see that 6 per day is 0. What I will do for BP meds is I will just fill that with 0. So what we can do is just type in df.fillNA and then pass in 0, comma, in place equal to true. And of course, I have to mention the column name. So what I will do is just type in BP meds, like that. Now when you run this code, we see that again, BP meds is now 0. Now for the rest, all three, I'm just going to drop them by using the not NA function. So I'll come over here and then actually copy this line, paste this 3 more times, paste it, let's say 3 more times, and then change it each and every single time. So first time will be heart rate, and then I will also do that for BMI, and I will do that for total as well. Now when you run this code, we see that glucose alone has 340 null values. So what I will do for this is this, I will find the mean and then round it off and then fill it with that value. So what I will do is mean will be df of glucose dot mean. I will round this to be safe. Round this value, and then I will type in df of glucose dot fill na, and then type in the mean, comma in place equals to true. Nice. So now we have no null values. Let's just print the data set to show you like that. This is the top 5 records. Let's show you the bottom 5 as well. And nice. So up next, we will have to initialize our input label and our output label. Now, when we come to initialization, I want you to notice that this 10-year CHD column is what our model has to predict on. So what I will do is first create the output label to be this same column, df of 10-year CHD, like that. And I will convert this to a NumPy array because we will have to provide this to our model. I'll do that. And then I will drop this column off from our main data frame because we will also have to create the input label X, which doesn't contain this 10-year CHD. So I will mention the columns to be 10-year CHD, and then I will type in place equal to true, like that. And I will create our X to be NumPy array of this df dataset. And I will also scale this input label X because I see wide range of values for different features. So what I will do is just create the scales variable and then pass in the standard scalar operation, standard scalar dot fit underscore transform, pass in X, and then see if X is scaled. Let's just print that on a code. And we see that we have our scaled features like this. So what I will do now is split this data into 75% of training set and 25% of test set. So X train, comma X test, comma Y train, and similarly Y test, to be using the train test split function. I will pass in X scaled, comma Y, comma mention the test size to be 0.25. because we want our test set to be 25% of the entire data. Now let's run our code. We will have to run all of the cells above and then run this. Okay, and it worked. Nice. So now it's time to create the model itself. Let's create the model. And then first I will define the model to be logistic regression. And then I will type in model.fit, pass in the training data, xtrain, ytrain, like that. Now that our model is ready, let's just also make predictions off of our test set, model.predict, pass in the ytest, actually the xtest. And then we can evaluate this by using the accuracy score that we imported from scikit-learn metrics. Accuracy score, pass in the output label in terms of test set and also the prediction set to see the accuracy score. Let me just multiply this with 100 to see the percentage of accuracy. Let's run our code and we see that our model is 85% accurate. Now I also want to show you the confusion matrix as well. I will explain what this is, but let's first plot this and show you. So what we will have to do is import these two statements before actually using it. We actually import the confusion matrix and then we also want to display it. So we also import confusion matrix.display. So now what I will do is first create a variable confusion matrix and then define this to be using the confusion matrix that we just imported. We pass in the Y test just like we did for accuracy score. We also pass in Y pred. And then leave it like that. Now what I will do is create another variable display and then type in confusion matrix.display. Pass in the confusion matrix variable that we created, comma the display labels, to be actual 0 and actual 1. I will explain this in a second. So what I will do is type in display labels. Actually, rather than having this to be actual 0 and actual 1, I will have this to be 0 and 1. Now we will also have to set the figure size, so I will be using matplotlib for this one. Fig size to be 8, 6, like that. And then now I will display the plot. What I will do is type in display.plot and type in cmap to mention the colors, plt.cm. I'm going to use the red color, so just type in reds. You can also use the blue color, just type in blues. Similarly, just go on. Now I will also set the title to be confusion matrix. Also type in plt.show. And now it's good to run our code. As we run our code, you see the confusion matrix is not defined. We have to type in T over here. Now run our code. We see that this is the confusion matrix. A confusion matrix is a 2x2 matrix where the first element, that is 1, 1, will contain the total number of times when the true label, that is the actual output, is 0 and the predicted output is also 0. So 867 times the machine has predicted 0 and the actual output is also 0. Whereas when we come to 1, 2, we see that the actual output is 0, whereas the predicted output is 1. That is, the machine prediction is wrong. It predicted 1, but the actual output is 0. Whereas when you come down here, the true label, that is the actual output, is 1, but then the machine predicted 0. So when you come to the 2, 2, the final element, you see that the actual output and the predicted output is 1, and so this will be mentioned over here. So we see that the major predictions made by the model is 0, that's why we see 153, where the true label is 1, but then the predicted label is 153. So that's confusion matrix. That was logistic regression. Now, in this same scikit-learn linear model, there is also linear regression. And we have a video on that one as well, which is what I recommend you to watch next.